The Citroen Ami has a design flaw which causes the front suspension top mounts to rip apart. There's a rubber bush bonded to the top plate, and that fails, and the suspension then gets too much slack. So I've devised a strengthening plate that welds to the top of the top mounts to try and cure that problem. Right, I've roughly cut out two plates, bolted them to one of the broken top plates. I'll now take my flap disc and bring it down to the size of the plate, and then I'll put it in the lathe and turn a centre bore through that will give me clearance on the 21mm ring spanner I need for the top mount of the strut. So that's the 21mm spanner that needs to get into that recess, which you need to get through that as well. So that needs to be about 34mm diameter, the hole through that plate. So I'll chuck it up on the diameter there and turn the 34mm hole there. So this boss at an angle to this plate, so it's a bit wibbly wobbly drilling the hole, as you can see. We're just about there, a couple of millimetre more. That's the centre hole bored in it. Should be enough, I think, to get my spanner in there. If not, I can grind a bit off my spanner. There's one of the new top mounts. You notice that there's a gap there. There's the rubber bit sticks up above the surface slightly. So what I'm going to do is I'll tighten down these bolts here, compress this, and tack weld the plate to the top in a few places so it sits as low as possible, putting a bit of compression on that rubber. And that should work. Right, that's the plate all tack welded and clamped in the vise and clamped it up with the bolts. So it's got a bit of compression on the rubber. That should stop the rubber ripping out. That's a pair of these made now. So I'll just give them a lick of black paint, and then I'll fit them when I do my MOT preparation. I'm going to rust proof the chassis, I'll change my drive belt, and I'll change these top mounts. And that should stop any future problems with the top mounts. I've had two go already. I have to take it rather canny over speed humps, so that's what breaks them. Right, lick of black paint on them. Let them dry. Thank you. should be. Should be able to lower that now. There you go. There's the plate. Right, I need those torque bits for the top and the spanner. So 21. Tight, I might need a longer ratchet. Oh, that's it. See, this is the top mount. I don't know if there's much spring tension on that or not. No, there's not. I think it'll come off without a spring compressor. That's the one. 21. Persuade it coming off without dismantling the other part of the bearing, that bit of the bearing with the balls. That's what you don't want to come off. See if I can persuade that bit to stay down. That bit there. Yeah, no real need for a spring compressor, no. Need to go and find. Don't mind. And my new reinforced top mount. There's a little pip there that goes on. Just about lined up. That's it. And here is the ratchet. 21. And that plate goes on like
So, what is it? Yeah, goes on there. Maybe give it a quick coat of Lanoguard. Right, I've got my Lanoguard out. So you can get some underneath there. Normally get to. Go back in there. Something spoke in there to line the holes up. So you get a couple of bolts in. That's the near side back on. Tackle this other side. Still bonded that one. That way. I do believe. Right, front end back on again. We do the back and the underside for the Lanoguard